Stress and boredom are the major causes for developing bad habits. Think about it. When you're bored, you overeat, you grab snacks, you watch TV, whatever it may be. Or when you're stressed, you drink alcohol, you smoke a cigarette, you just lounge on the couch, whatever it may be. Stress and boredom is natural. You can never avoid that. But what you can do is learn how to manage stress and boredom. So there are different things that you can do. If you're bored, enroll in a dragon boat race with some friends, make new friends, or, you know, do some bouldering or rock climbing. Do something more active, so just so that you're not bored and choose towards being sedentary. As for stress, you can take off your mind from stress by meditating or reading a book, or try replacing it. You cannot stop bad habits, but what you can do is replace it. Hence, people who smoke, they go towards chewing nicotine gum. Or people who quit smoking, they end up eating more. So you just have to be mindful to look for habits that you can replace that are actually good habits. So how do you replace bad habits? First, choose a substitute. So if you're always lounging, playing video games, watching movies, maybe you should just turn off the TV more or have restrictions as to how many hours you can watch or play video games or drink alcohol, whatever it may be, or overeat. So you just have to find substitutes. Second, cut out as many triggers as possible. Remember, the environment sets triggers and cues to bad habits. So if you drink when you're out with friends, maybe you should just try to do something else instead of drinking while socializing. You could just, again, enroll in some healthy fitness classes or cooking classes or anything that reinforces good habits. When you're watching movies, instead of grabbing popcorn, maybe just chew gum. You still have that gnawing sensation, that chewing, that grinding of teeth. So that replaces eating popcorn with just chewing a gum. You don't need to be someone else. You just need to return to the old you. Think about it. Bad habits, you weren't born with them. In fact, you developed them through your environment, through your surroundings, through your peers, through your friends. So think about when you developed this bad habit. Think about the time before you developed that bad habit. You just have to return to that old person, that old time. You don't need to quit smoking. You just have to return to being a non-smoker. You don't have to quit drinking either. You just have to return to the time when you didn't drink as much, or overeating as well, whatever that bad habit may be. Could be eating dessert after every meal. Just think about the time when you didn't eat dessert after every meal. You could return to that type of person. You also need to be aware and very mindful. Now, habits happen automatically, subconsciously. So you just have to be mindful as to when these bad habits happen, because when you do, and when you are mindful, then you realize when it happens and you could easily quit it. You want to know when your bad habits happen. Who you're with, the surroundings you're at, what time you usually do it, all these different things. Now when you track it, you can be more mindful of it and you can make changes because of that. Remember, what you don't journal, what you don't track, what you don't write down, you can't improve upon. So you need to measure, you need to find out about when, how, or what are the occasions when the bad habits happen. Make your habits quantifiable. So if instead of just saying, you know, I'm gonna quit drinking, you could say, I'm gonna limit myself to one drink. Again, we live in a day and age where, you know, all these temptations are abundant. So you can't expect to go zero, although there are some people that can do that. They go cold turkey. But just try making small improvements again. So instead of drinking as much as you can or until you're drunk, you wanna drink maybe one less drink. Or you want to have half a slice less of dessert.